Hello students, I am Ravindra Bidre, math teacher from Chandrakant Patil Public School, Kalburgi. Once again, I am with you to the fifth video session with a new concept for the 7th and 8th class. In this session, let me explain about the properties of multiplication of integers. Properties of multiplication of integers. First one, closure under multiplication. Observe the following examples. First, you see the statements, then the observation. First one, minus 20 into minus 5 is equal to plus 100. Product is an integer. Minus 20 is an integer and minus 5 is an integer. The product is also an integer. Second one, minus 15 into 17 is equal to 255. Product is an integer. Third one, 9 into 16 is equal to 144. Product is an integer. Fourth one, 14 into minus 5 is equal to minus 70. Product is an integer. By the observation, we can conclude that the product of two integers is again an integer. So we say that integers are closed under multiplication. Integers are closed under multiplication. In general, if A and B are two integers, then A into B is an integer for all integers A and B. Next, I will go to the another property. Commutativity of multiplication. Consider the following examples. 3 into minus 4 is equal to minus 12. Or minus 4 into 3 is equal to minus 12. We observe that 3 into minus 4 is equal to minus 4 into 3. Second example, minus 12 into 0 is equal to 0. 0 into minus 12 is equal to 0. We observe that minus 12 into 0 is equal to 0 into minus 12. Third one, 6 into 8 is equal to 48. Or 8 into 6 is equal to 48. Then 6 into 8 is equal to 8 into 6. By the above examples, we observe that multiplication is commutative for integers. Multiplication is commutative for integers. In general, for any two integers A and B, A into B is equal to B into A. The next property is multiplication by 0. Consider the following examples. First one, minus 3 into 0 is equal to 0. Second one, 0 into minus 5 is equal to 0. Third one, 6 into 0 is equal to 0. Fourth one, 0 into 8 is equal to 0. This shows that the product of any integer and 0 is 0. In general, for any integer A, then A into 0 is equal to 0 into A is equal to 0. The next property is multiplicative identity. Consider the following examples. 1, minus 3 into 1 is equal to minus 3. 4 into 1 is equal to 4. 1 into minus 5 is equal to minus 5. 1 into 7 is equal to 7. By above examples, we can say that 1 is a multiplicative identity for integers. In general, for any integer A, we have A into 1 is equal to 1 into A is equal to A. Now you remember the sum points. First one, 0 is the additive identity. Second one, 1 is the multiplicative identity. Third one, we get the additive inverse of an integer A when we multiply minus 1 to A. That is, A into minus 1 is equal to minus 1 into A is equal to minus A. That is, the additive inverse of A. So, this completes this session. Now, worksheet number 5 is given to you and you can solve it. Thank you, students.